Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today I'm going to show you how to use screen zoom on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you by a community of more than 350 contributors. See how you can become a part of it at MacMost.com/Patreon. So the zoom option has been around on Macs for like forever. It's a great option to be able to read hard to see text or focus in on a certain part of the screen for various reasons. There are tons of ways to customize it too. So to turn on zoom, you need to go and check your settings. In System Preferences, if you go to Accessibility and then look for zoom on the left, you'll see how you have things currently set up and you can make changes. So for instance here, I've got the keyboard shortcuts turned on, but the trackpad gestures turned off. And I could switch between them or have both. So for instance, I could turn on the trackpad gestures and I could see that I have to use a key. So I'm going to use the default control key there. And when I use control and then go with two fingers up on my trackpad, it zooms in. I can continue to zoom in and see things clearer. Just continue to hold that control key down and move my two fingers down, and it will zoom back out. But if I go and use the keyboard shortcuts, then I can either use Option Command 8 to turn it on and then the same thing to turn it off, or I can just use Option Command and then the plus or minus keys, or technically the minus or equal keys, right, with the Option and Command key. And that will start zooming it in steps and zooming it out in steps. So that's how you turn it on, but it doesn't have to look exactly like you just saw it. You can customize how it works. So I don't like it when it shows the entire screen zoomed in like that. I'd rather have it do it where the zoom style is set to picture in picture. So in this case, if I were to zoom in, I instantly get this square area and it moves with my cursor and I can focus on anything I want. The rest of the screen remains the same. And I can customize this. So once I have picture in picture selected, I can click options. And I could set the window position to stationary so it doesn't move with the cursor. Have it move with the cursor or have it go along the edge. So for instance, if I do that, you can see I get this area here on the edge of the screen. Furthermore, I can adjust the size and location. So in this case, I could adjust the size and location of the part at the edge or even drag it to the other edge of the screen or the bottom or the top. If I were to go in and change the picture in picture options to follow the mouse cursor and then adjust size and location, then it's going to allow me to drag the edges of this window here so I can adjust the size of that. Make it as large or as small as I want. There are also a few other options here, like the ability to invert colors inside. So now you can see the colors are inverted here. I can hold some keys, like in this case the control and option key, and it temporarily brings up the zoom window. I can even detach the zoom window view from the pointer. Now if you change from picture in picture to full screen, the options are different here. You get a maximum zoom and a minimum zoom. You can have the screen flash when there's a notification because you may be zoomed in and not see the notification appear in the upper right hand corner. There's also the option to have the zoom follow keyboard focus. So when I turn that on and I go into, say, pages and I zoom in, now as I move the cursor, the zoomed area will move with it. So you may notice here under the keyboard shortcuts, one of them is unassigned. And it doesn't seem that there's a way for you to customize these. But there actually is. If you go into Keyboard System Preferences and you go to Shortcuts, one of the options is Accessibility and one of the categories under Accessibility is Zoom. And you can see those same shortcuts here. So you can actually change these to something else and of course assign this one that doesn't have a keyboard shortcut.
Using the zoom mode is part of the accessibility options on your Mac, but it can be really used by everybody. As a developer, I often use it to work on screen layouts to get everything just perfect. Designers, I'm sure, use it to be able to zoom in on a particular part of an image and work with colors or at the pixel level of the image. If you just go to a lot of web pages, you're probably going to eventually end up with one where the text maybe is a little bit too small for you to be able to read something in a corner, or at least read it comfortably. And you can use zoom to actually quickly zoom in on that.